Hey everyone, it's Book of Catherine. Today I'd like to share two examples of how you can use your platform and your influence to influence the Bill of Rights around the globe. Remember, America is the only one that has the 10 Bill of Rights: the freedom to gather, the freedom to speak, the freedom of religion, many, many freedoms that the majority of the world does not have. We have the ability to self-govern, and most peoples are not self-governed. And we have the amazing ability with our platforms to encourage people to rise up and become self-governed. One of those peoples currently is Iran. They are fighting for the ability to become self-governed again. In fact, their own constitution calls for them to be self-governed, and their current government and regime is going against their actual constitution. And people have been dying for generations and are currently dying. And today's video is going to be dedicated to one of those young gentlemen that has recently died, and I'm going to dance for him. And that gentleman is this one right here.
Protest that started and accelerated in November clearly signaled the Iranian people just had enough. They're fed up. They're fed up with the regime's economic failures. They're fed up with the kleptocrats. And they're fed up with a regime that denies them basic fundamental human dignity that comes from each of us as the nature of our humanness. It's not one age group. It's not one class or gender lifting their voices. It's female students in Tehran. It's teachers in Mashhad. It's younger men in Mershar. One of those young men was Puya Bakhtiari. Puya was an electrical engineer full of life who loved singing the Elvis song, Can't Help Falling in Love with You. And he was sick of what he called criminal and corrupt Iranian leadership. Last month, he joined his countrymen on the streets in protest. Puya's mother, Nahid, went to the protest with him. They promised that they would hold hands to stay together. But as you've watched the videos, you've seen there was chaos. And when the security forces started attacking the crowd, they became separated. Then Nahid experienced every parent's worst nightmare. She saw fellow protesters holding her son's lifeless body. He'd been shot in the head by security forces of the Iranian regime. Today, Nahid grieves with so many other parents, so many other amazing.
Which is why America has more people in jail than any other country. Other countries just shoot people in the head. So today I'm going to dance for him. I am so proud that we're carrying on the vision of Harriet Tubman. These people do not have the freedoms that we extended to every American living within this nation's borders. This nation's now using sanctions to give that to the peoples who want them internationally, as we once used to do back in the 1800s, and we stopped doing 30 years ago. We've started doing it again. 2 days later, the behavior that led, that we actually see in Iran, was exhibited by another influencer, also on an American stage. A criticism, a throwing out of somebody by their class or by their DNA. They were not fit to be equal. Something that Iranians are fighting for and dying for. And instead of using their platform to throw their support behind the Iranians and fight for their equal rights, or for any of the 55 countries around the world who are dying for that, or any of the other dictatorships or socialist countries who don't have that around the world, instead they chose to increase that type of behavior here in America and cheer for it.
Right. I mean, when I got hired, Lauren told me, you're going to be the next Eddie Murphy. And then a year later, he said, no, you're not.
You said it, Chris Rock. And just to piggyback.
We're good on that. Thank you. Yeah. Sorry about that, fellas. Please continue.
What's he apologizing for?
Joe Piscopo.
Who the hell was that? Joe Piscopo. And how dare someone of another DNA show up on the stage with a row of people of another DNA? That is the essential othering that is happening in Iran, that people are being thrown in jail for, that we are now, that Harriet Tubman, all these people died. Honestly, way back, we've been learning in Alexandria and in Rome. 2,000 years ago, it was like Manhattan. It was a metropolis. All nations came together of all different languages. They were all living together, all in the Roman Empire and the Mediterranean. Everyone was mixing. That's why people look up, who are black, look up their DNA and they find out they're European. There are even black Roman emperors, for heaven's sakes. Roman emperors were sleeping with Cleopatra. I mean, it was, no one saw color back then. It was a new thing that was just brought up recently in order to raise up power and destroy the equality of the American dream. Because now when you say things like, oh, royals, it's in their blood, we don't really notice anything because we're so used to talking about people and what they're worth according to their DNA. And so we're so focused on America that we've stopped fighting for the people of Iran or anybody else that's in a regime that had what America once had. America won freedom, and now the people who actually won freedom from slavery are not fighting for freedom of the slaves out there in the rest of the world. And shame on them for using their platform to deter and throw out others, instead of encouraging the freedom of others in the world. I'm going to use my platform to fight for the freedom of those in Iran. So this is for you. Because an electrical engineer in Iran had more bravery than millionaires like Eddie Murphy or Dave Chappelle have on Saturday Night Live, because the writers just told them, do this, our advertisers would love it. Thing is they don't tell them their advertisers are the monarchies of Germany, who are very, very proud about DNA and their race. That's why Rome had such a hard time defeating them. Their pride in their race. The rest of the world was mixing. They didn't care about their DNA. Oh, but Germany did. And if they get to care, you to care about your DNA for the first time, then Germany has won. But they haven't won me yet. And they haven't won Iran. Not yet. My thanks to Mike Pompeo for making me aware. This is Can't Help Falling in Love by Elvis. Take my whole life too. Freedom of Iran, and for all of its people, may you dance, may you have everything you ever want, and to the judges, may you be toppled. Peace out, everyone. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Use your words and your platform well. Let freedom ring.